Alright guys, here's the engine. It's back apart again. I'm believing my springs are weak. They seem extremely weak. I mean, there's hardly any pressure on those. It's supposed to be a little harder than that to press your valves. That's where I'm getting that valve popping at when it was idling up. And that, and I took the front cover back. I took the whole front shroud off. This is a stock brakes coil, which is going to get updated to a hot spark. But I don't know if you guys can see it. Let me zoom you guys in. See that? This crank's been shaved. This been cut off. And I don't know how well the camera will pick it up. But you see that Z type of keyway in there? That's an offset, so it sets the timing, advance the timing a little bit. So we're gonna get into this motor and see what's going on. And I don't know what's going on with this engine. I have no clue yet. Today we're gonna test out some Husky 10 piece deep socket set. They're 6.38. They're right here. So we're gonna test these suckers out. The size they include is 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and 19. And anything higher than that, I go with half inch. Let's start with draining the oil first. Let's get the oil out of here. Yeah, I know I just put it in here, but you know, this engine needed to break in with some clean oil anyway, so. Let's get the oil drained. Oh yeah, I'm glad I did him draining it. That crap looks like, that stuff looks nasty, dude. Look at that nasty oil. And that was clean oil I put in there, too. That's nasty, guys. Let's say I don't have it. That was clean oil I put in this block. It smells gas fouled. It smells really bad. Like it's been flooding itself. Best way to put it. Like somebody dumped a gallon of gas inside of the sucker. Yeah, that's what it smells like. So, let's get this side spun around. Get you guys up there a little closer. Let's, I think those are 13s. Or I'm gonna go 14. Nope, 13. So far, I don't, the second rail is okay, but I'm having a little bit of problem getting these off. It's not 13. Yeah. It's SAE. But I think I can get away with using 13. Yeah, I better not. Give me a second. Let me go get the proper tools for it. I don't have much tools. I thought they would be metric, but less slop in it. Of course, I don't know if my socket's wore out or not. Either they're my dad's set. 9 tight. Well, I don't know if they were tight or not. That looks like it's been homemade, guys. That looks homemade. Homemade guard. And I want to also replace that seal too while I'm at it. Snap-on 3/8. That's an old socket, guys. Snap-on 3/8. Patent number. That's old, guys. So I guess we're not gonna test out my new socket set. Cause it's all metric. Yeah, it's not even metric. Darn it! Can't have metric. It's all standard. SAE. So this is the year that Briggs used standard size, so it's still American made done. It's kind of shocking. Just make sure they're all the same size, which they are. Yeah, this never had a it had it set up for a governor. But there's your governor ride, but the case was never drilled for it. It's got a nice roller bearing. This might have been what I'm getting into, guys, is trying to see. I gotta mic the cam and see what the cam is. But it's gonna be interesting, guys. Hoping none of this fall out. No, it won't. So that's good. There we go. Yeah, looks like metal shavings inside the thing. Let's go back up to half inch. Yep, half inch on top ends. You guys can't see that, can you? There we go. So I want you guys to come along with the adventure. I don't know what I'm getting my hands into right now. I could be in a world of hurt right now. I don't know. I have no clue, guys. So we're gonna invest this motor pretty good. Blown black, guys, I can tell you that much. Oh yeah, she's blown heavy black. Ah, it's got an updated piston in it. So this motor is or was or whatever you want to call it. Got an oil or gas residue on top of the piston. Like a 30.25, so I think it's 20 over or 25 over. They don't know. There is play in that. I don't like that at all. I don't know if you guys can hear it. Let me get this down to you guys so you guys can see it. There you go. I think it means 25 foul over or under. But look at that play. And that should be tighter than that in that cylinder home, and it's not. It's pretty loose in that cylinder home. Got a bad ring in it. I don't feel it's got a lip. Oh well, not really. Don't have much wrong with the internal of the block. It just got to be homed. So we got that figured out. Great. Now how do I get the cam out? Sorry guys, I'm just trying to figure this problem out that I have. It's got a hatch in it, so still got a factory hatch. That's good. Let me go get my micrometer and see if these two valves are open in the same distance. Alright guys, got my micrometer out. Let's see if we got that valve on the high side. Okay, that valve's on the high side. And the valves are open on the same heights. Let's see what the bore is. almost 2.6 on the bore size. Let me redo that again. Roughly around there. I could say one thing, it does have an updated dipper, which is good. Let's see, I got that on the rod's loose. And that's not good. I don't like when I hear the rod loose in this engine. This engine is going to need a complete overhaul. See if we can get the crank out. Crank out. Should be able to tap on that flywheel. Thank you. go. Here's that thing I was telling you about, that offset keyway. This is fun, guys. That's when you can't see in the hole. Go. Yeah, they're soft, guys. But I got a bigger problem. I like how that valve looks, guys. And that valve hasn't been seating right either. I'm assuming the valve seat's bad on this engine. Or valve guide. I don't know if you can replace these guides or not. Oh, this valve does not want to come out my way. Okay. We can play two for that. Alright, this valve is really irritating me now. Thank you. God, guys. Does it take that long to get a freaking valve out? Oh my God. Sorry, guys. But that was ridiculous. Valve springs more wore out than the intake valve. Now, yeah. Duh. Wake up, smell coffee, Rose. Oh, man. I gotta go inside and take the thing off before I can get the crank out. Yeah, we're getting there, guys. Slowly. We're getting there. Believe me, we're getting there. Smaller than 3/8, so. Alright. Yeah, right on the nut. NSK comes to the rescue. Nope, NSK does not come to the rescue. Oh, yes, okay, split. That was what? That was a 5/16 that I needed. Those two just broke loose. Interesting dipper. Burn don't look too bad. Wrist spin is no slop in the wrist. That's the scoring on the piston. The rings look a little wore out. Original brakes crank. Connecting rod, I mean. Original brakes connecting rod. Everything else checks out on the crank, on the connecting rod. Everything looks good there. Cylinder home. Well, I don't know about cylinder home yet. Can't squeeze my hand all there. There's no lip in the cylinder. That's even better. Got the cam out. Let's see the cam. Cam is doesn't look wore out, I should say. Cam doesn't look that old. go. Crank is out now. See what my tappets look like. Tappets looks great. Been ground down on the tappet side a little bit. Ooh, the crank is, case is cracked. Oh boy. Oh boy, that ain't good. Looks like I'm going to get a new case. Case is cracked, guys. I don't know how well you can see that. The case is shot. See it? There's where the other part of the noise come from. So yeah, there's what's wrong with the block. Block is toast. So, see you guys later then. Let me just mic the cam and see what's going on with the cam. See if this is a stock cam or bored out cam. Let's find out. The bored out cam is 3-something. Thousand. The lobe heights. In millimeters be 25, but in inches 0.9. Let's see. Yeah, 0.9 thou. And that's 1 thou in the opening. Let's see what the crank is. Crank is okay a little bit. So that connector knob is a little wore out. Just a tad bit wore. So there's my question to the answer then, guys. And that's a stock Briggs. A lot of stock Briggs stuff in this. So, stock connecting rod, stock crank, broken block, that all leads up to one thing. I got screwed. Seen a sucker coming today, that day. So, we're going to have to get a new block. And hopefully I can still get one for this engine. Still got good parts here, I'm not going to scrap them. But it's just going to be a slow build here. And I even think the crank cam, the cam is stock on this too. I don't think the cam's bored out. So, catch you guys later then.